Proactive Investors oil and gas correspondent Jamie Ashcroft is with me now on the line. Jamie, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Andrew.
News today from Angus Energy, wrapping up this drill program at Lidsey. Jamie, what more do we know? Bring us up to date.
Yeah, it's been an interesting item in that it's another well that's got off to a successful start in what's kind of a growing UK onshore play. So this Lidsey well, it's one of a number of wells onshore UK that's been looking to follow up the successes that UK Oil and Gas and its partners had at Horse Hill. And at Lidsey, which is down on the south coast, so they've identified multiple zones. They're going to advance it, take it forward, and it's another positive step, albeit some material results are still awaited.
Well, give us a bit more detail on that, Jamie. What are the plans going forward for Angus at Lidsey?
Yeah, so the company indicated that there's more analysis to be done and more work to be done on defining certain elements of the project, but they do say that they're going to be advancing it through to production. And I guess for investors' point of view, we're all going to be waiting to see what the production stats look like, how productive that well is, and then I guess we'll all be then looking to the other projects that are kind of similar and trying to discern what that means for the play more generally. I mean, that's been the narrative throughout here.
And of course, a bit of a knockback, a bit of a setback, you could say, for UK Oil and Gas during the week. Yeah, you were reporting on these complications at Broadford Bridge. What were some of the issues?
Yeah, that's right. Well, Broadford Bridge, for context, that's like Lidsey, that's another project that is targeting similar zones that were successful at Horse Hill. It's one of these follow-up projects. And like Lidsey, Broadford Bridge is a bit further down the line, but a few weeks ago, like Lidsey, they encountered multiple zones. It all looked fantastic, and then they needed to advance to testing. Now, when they did testing, they identified some problems related to some of the cementing in the well, and that's it impeded the testing process. So they've got more work over to do there. They're going to do some additional operations to kind of clean that up and have that operating to a level at which they can test it effectively. And again, this is another area where investors are going to have to wait and see exactly what the numbers are going to look like and really make a judgment of, has this been a success and does this project equate to the kind of results that we're seeing at Horse Hill.
Good to speak to you, Jamie. Thank you.
No problem at all.